Hi, I'm Matthew Buzzy from PC Mag, and as the debate over right to repair grows and discussions around sustainability, companies are having to reassess their objectives and their plans, sort of a long-term overview. And we're here with Drew from Dell to discuss their plans and their goals long-term, moving as far into 2030, I understand, some objectives they like to hit. And this is Concept Luna, which is a project sort of aiming to sort of achieve these goals by that time frame, a holistic approach, as well as a individual concrete laptop that we can show you the kind of progress they've made so far. So Drew, show us what this is and sort of what Dell's goals are long-term.
Yeah, so obviously in order to reach our 2030 goals for sustainability, we really had to reconsider the entire PC and how we build it. That's both architecturally how it's done, the materials and sustainability aspects we put into it. We've already been doing a lot of sustainable materials and packaging, but we really needed to reconsider the entire architecture. So the biggest difference is, as you described right to repair, we drove towards right to repair opportunities, looked for how we can make this as easy to disassemble as possible so that we can harvest back parts and reuse those parts in other products, as well as make it easier to recycle if that's the case at the end of its life. So Concept Luna does that through, in essence, four screws remove the ability for us to take out two keystones. These two keystones allow us to, when they're removed, to take out the keyboard. This keyboard just lifts out very simply. This keyboard obviously is one of the struggles is its life because it probably goes through one use. So we designed very much for recycling. Gives us direct access to the battery and IO board. And you'll also notice there's no motherboard in the base. We've moved the motherboard to the hinge up in order to allow for better thermals and in essence, no ingress. So it's passive that allows for a longer life. And then as well, when I remove the keystone for the display, this allows me to simply slide out the display. I'm going to use a suction cup. When I slide this out, I can now expose that the motherboard is mounted on the back, as well as the heatsink. This makes it very easy to service the motherboard as well as service the display. We want our customers to be able to repair these things simply themselves so that the life will continue as long as possible, as well as allow us to harvest back these parts in the simplest fashion. We've designed it to have standard mounts so that we know that we could install it in another system, and we can take it back by harvesting it, we can certify it, check that it's actually working, working with Intel to understand maybe it started as like an i7 level and now it's, you know, at an i5 level, and we can then take that, reuse it in a new product, sell it to a new customer who's excited to get something that they know is a sustainable option, and as well as still comes with a, you know, warranty from Dell and has all those proof of purchase.
So some of you out there may not have seen the interior of laptops as much as I have through demos like this. You should know that that is very much not what they normally look like. Dell's done a lot of work here. And again, this is a concept. It's not a product that will be as is for sale, but a lot of work here conceptually and design-wise to make a laptop that can come apart, can be repaired with individual pieces. Some will age faster than others. You mentioned before, the keyboard obviously is something that's going to take a physical beating compared to some of the internal components, which can be swapped pretty easily. A panel sometimes goes, removing that as you saw. So these are sort of the sort of bigger picture and concept, problems that need to be solved. We've seen some full product efforts on the market, like the Framework laptop, which is our favorite sort of pick for a DIY and upgradable, swappable component modular design. And this had some of the same elements. Obviously, this is even more piece by piece, and from a big manufacturer like Dell, it's really promising to see. But 2030, a long way off. These are hard things to do to make both a design that can incorporate these and a program that can actually service and repair and fix and offer sustainability and recycling. So a lot of long-term goals. Anything else you'd like to say about Concept Luna?
No, I'm excited. I think you'll start to slowly see these in the next generations of our products.
Cool. Thank you so much for watching. Tune in to the rest of our CES coverage at PCMag.com.